Today we're doing a build that will fool your foes and keep your DM on their toes. Today I bring you the ultimate shape changer. The concept for this build is that you are the ultimate shape changer. You can change your shape into so many different forms for so many utility aspects. I think it's a really fun concept and one I'm excited to jump into. Now, to get this party started, we are going to begin with our lineage, and we have to be a changeling. You can't be the ultimate shape changer without being a changeling. Changelings give us the ability to change our face, our appearance, our voice, and I think all of those things coming together, as long as we're basically relatively the same size, we can change to any sort of humanoid. That's powerful. As for our stats, we're going to be going our primary into wisdom, secondary into constitution, tertiary into dexterity, and anything remaining goes into charisma. As for our leveling structure, we're going to go 2 into moon druid, 3 into fey wanderer ranger, and the remainder will go into druid. So let's talk about our early levels. Right off the get-go, we're going to want to make sure that our background gives us some languages. Languages are going to be really important for this build because we're going to be deceiving people with our disguises, and being able to speak some really common languages can make us have some really common disguises. So Dwarven and Elvish are great use cases for having those languages. So I'm going to drop tools in order to have more languages. So we're coming out the gate with 4 languages, including Common, which can be enough to kind of get us through what we need to do. Our first 2 levels in Druid make us a Moon Druid, a specialized shape changer. So now not only can we change our image to any humanoid, now we can change it to many different animals on top of that. I love that mixture. I think it's awesome. Not only that, our strength is going to be out the damn wall. Wazoo. Moon druids are so powerful at the beginning of the game that it really gives us time to do some investment levels. Moon druids from levels 2 to 5 are just super OP. So we're going to use those levels to basically set our groundwork for the rest of our build, and use that power to carry us until then. Now, those 3 levels into Ranger are going to give us several different things. The first is an expertise. The expertise I'm going to be taking is either in deception or performance, whichever one the DM calls for more when you're disguised. And you can even ask which one they're going to call for more and just take that one. Level 2 brings us a fighting style. Now, we're really not going to be using a lot of different weapons, so it's kind of boring, but I just went with the defense fighting style for that +1 AC, which druids are really going to appreciate when they're not wild-shaped. And this might even give you a +1 AC when you are wild shape, ask your DM, but probably not because you are unarmored. But the reason we're truly here is for Fey Wander. What Fey Wander is going to do, it's going to give us an additional D4 of damage once per turn of psychic damage. What we're really here for is Otherworldly Glamour. What Otherworldly Glamour is going to do for us is we can take our wisdom modifier and add it to any of our charisma skill checks. Persuasion, deception, performance, intimidation, all of them. And that's pretty bonkers, and it's really the only way that a druid can be a really powerful face, and that's what we want here, a druid who is a really powerful face. Now, in between our proficiency, our expertise, our charisma, and our wisdom being stacked together, we can have some really, really crazy face skills with this build. Now we're done with Ranger, we're going to be going back into Druid, and we're going to continue into Druid forever. So this is a good time to kind of start mentioning our cantrips, right? I said we're not going to be using weapons, so I'm not really going to push for extra attack. What cantrips am I using? Well, there's 2 that really stand out to me. The first is Primal Savagery. I like the idea of us morphing just our hand into a claw and scratching somebody, and that being our main way of fighting up close. And we're gonna have a shield in the other hand, worth mentioning now. As for our more ranged cantrip, it's still not gonna be a lot of range, kind of more medium range. I'm thinking Thorn Whip, but instead of it being a Thorn Whip, I like the idea of flavoring it, that our arm turns into like a big tentacle, a big octopus tentacle, and we go whip it out there, hit someone, and try and drag them towards us if we so choose. I think that's pretty neat. What really stands out to me about this build is the mixture of wild shape with your shape change. I think there's so many cool things you can do with that. We can begin an infiltration by turning into a spider, crawling under the door. We look around, we see who's here, we see what's going on. We then walk into the guards room, transform ourselves into one of the guards, go ahead and start putting on a guard uniform, begin walking around the area as a guard, find whatever target we're going for, grab it, wild shape, get out of there. That's just one combination. There's a ton of different combinations you can do between those 2 things, and I think it's rad. Welcome to today's segment of Sage just ranting. I think it's absolutely ridiculous that druids do not get the alter self spell. It's crazy to me. It's like you are altering yourself to be more bestial in many different ways, and it's just stupid that we can't use it. It's not even that good of a spell, but it's like, I want it on this build. Why? Well, one of the things it allows is cool. Being able to kind of transform, to be able to breathe underwater is kind of neat. I like how it's an in-between. You're kind of half turning yourself into a creature, and I want to totally do that with this build, but instead of being limited to what alter self myself tells me, I would try and expand some ideas. Maybe instead of making myself have an aquatic form or bestial hands, I get like gecko hands and I can sit there and climb up walls using my gecko hands. Or I like the idea of basically turning our eyes into panther eyes so we can now have dark vision. Just little things like that that aren't overpowered but are super flavorful for this build, I think are awesome. So it's a real letdown that we don't get alter self, but I would ask my DM if they would allow it on my spell list for this particular build. I find me ranting about this more often with druids than anyone else. It's like, why don't they have the web spell? Why don't they have spider climb? And alter self is the new one on that list. Super annoying. But speaking of our spells, there's a couple that stand out to me that we can do some neat things with. Enhance ability. I think enhance ability, it references animals, and I like the idea that instead of us being enhanced in different ways, we get enhanced by partially making ourselves an animal. So like dexterity, we get cat legs, or for bear strength, we get literal bear arms. Things like that I think are pretty cool. This build is ultimately going to be mostly just a moon druid. We're going to be wild shaping, casting our fight winning spell beforehand, and throwing in some cantrips in between when we're not wild shaped. It's going to be stock standard, just with a different flavor and being much more of a face than otherwise would be possible. I think it's really cool how all of the flavor of this build really comes together before level 5 and we can start doing all those interesting infiltration things as a druid. I think it's tons of fun. So the D&D Daily team is going to begin making some adventures. What I want to hear from you guys is, what adventure would you want us to make that you would just absolutely love playing? Let me know in the comments down below, and if you see a cool one down there, make sure to thumbs it up so I know which ones are the most popular, so I know what you guys want. I think it would be really fun to build you guys some adventures. I want to give a shout out to our amazing Patreon member, Sean M. Sean M is the absolute man. Thank you so much for your support. And with that, my friends, I hope you have yourselves an incredible day, and I'll catch you on the next one. See you then.